Introduction. A charger particle can be accelerated in different ways. A. Attraction by opposite charge. B. Repulsion by same charge. C. Attraction or repulsion by a magnetic field. D. By incident photons. And E. A radioactive nucleus can emit accelerated particles, both charged and uncharged. But today we know that in an isolated non-radioactive atom, there are two types of forces acting on its electrons. They are attraction from the nucleus and repulsion between electrons. In hydrogen atom, attraction from the nucleus only. But these forces cannot make the electrons in an atom in consistent motion. The matter wave experiments conducted by George P. Thomson and Davison and Germer are by artificially accelerated electrons. The electron beams are created by applying high voltages between the negative and positive terminals. But in an atom, there is no such a force which can consistently accelerate its electrons. So the present wave mechanical model of atom is simply not correct. Since there is no motion, there must be a force which prevents the electrons from falling into the positive charged nucleus. Volume of atoms and elastic nature of atoms. For example, gas atoms move randomly in high speed and bounce back when they collide with other atoms or its container indicate that the nucleus of an atom is surrounded by a form of elastic matter. I name this matter as space matter. So, there are three factors that determine the electron configuration in a multi-electron atom. They are A. Attraction from the nucleus. B. Repulsion between electrons. And C. Buoyant force exerted by space matter. Buoyant force is the only force that prevents the innermost electrons of an atom from falling into the nucleus. For the electrons other than one nearest to the nucleus, repulsion with the electrons in the inner region as well as the buoyant force exerted by space matter keep the electrons in an atom in its respective positions. Since an atom of an element creates its own characteristic pattern of spectral lines when excited, and in cold state the same atom creates absorption lines in the same frequencies that the atom creates its emission lines, we can conclude that the electrons in an atom are situated in resonant columns. When a low energy electron collides with a multi-electron atom, the atom emits long wavelength radiations. But when a high energy electron collides with the same atom, the atom can emit both shorter and longer wavelength radiations. As a low energy electron can only excite an atom's outer electrons, a high energy electron is capable of penetrating outer region of the atom and to excite inner electrons. So we can understand that the space matter density in the inner region of an atom is greater and it decreases with the increasing of the distance from the nucleus, and also this difference in densities creates different resonant columns in an atom. As the density of space matter increases, the resonant frequency of that region is also increases. The shortest wavelength radiation that one atom can emit depends on its atomic mass. For example, heavy atoms like tungsten emit hard X-rays when its innermost electrons are excited. But the shortest wavelength radiation that can be emitted by the lightest element, hydrogen, is in the shortest wavelength Lyman series. Since the density differences between inner and outer regions, when an electron is excited in an atom, for every oscillation towards the direction of the nucleus, the high density space matter in the inner region of the atom expels the electron to an outer low density space matter region. This is the reason for the jumping of an electron with the emission of a photon. Short description for the new atom model. An atom has a tiny, denser nucleus. Most of the mass of an atom is concentrated in its nucleus. The nucleus of the atom is surrounded by space matter. Watch video space matter. The density of space matter is greater at the near surface of the nucleus and it decreases with the increasing of the distance from the nucleus. Since each of the different space matter regions with the precise radiuses from the center of the nucleus has unique densities, each of those regions act as resonant columns with unique natural frequencies. An atom has enormous number of resonant columns in it, and the electrons in an atom are situated in resonant columns. We can call a resonant column in an atom as a shell. There are three types of shells in an atom. 1. Electron shells. The electron shells in an atom are the regions in which the electrons are configured in an atom when the atom is in non-excited state. Hydrogen and helium have one electron shell. 2. Transitory shells. Transitory shells are the regions in which the electrons can jump from the electron shells when the atom is in excited state. An atom has enormous number of transitory shells in it. For example, even though a hydrogen atom has only one electron shell in it, highly pressurized hydrogen can emit a nearly continuous spectrum of radiations when extremely excited. The radiations other than the shortest wavelength radiation that emitted by a hydrogen atom are emitted from its transitory shells. This fact also indicates that the radius of a hydrogen atom is much greater than the radius of its electron shell. Watch video line spectrum of hydrogen atom. 3. Inner transitory shells. The inner transitory shells are the shells that inside of the innermost electron shell of an atom. In the pair production of one electron and one positron, when a high energy photon is passed through near a heavy atomic nucleus, the innermost transitory shell plays the important role. That is, the density of space matter at the near surface of the nuclei of heavy atoms like tungsten is sufficient for the production of electron-positron pair when a sufficiently energetic photon is passed through it. So it is clear that a heavy atomic nucleus can hold a greater amount of space matter than a low-mass atomic nucleus. When a pair production occurs, the equal amount of space matter will be entered from outside of the atom, and the space matter density in the shells of the atom will be always maintained. Watch video pair production. Important conclusions. In an atom, there is no such a force which can consistently accelerate its electrons. So, the present wave mechanical model of atom is wrong. Volume of atoms and elastic nature of atoms indicates that the nucleus of an atom is surrounded by a form of elastic matter. An atom has enormous number of resonant columns in it, and the electrons in an atom are situated in resonant columns. Photons are emitted when electrons oscillate, and the frequency of photons will be the frequency of oscillating electrons. The radius of an atom is greater than the radius of its outermost electron shell. For more videos and articles, please visit my website www.physics-edu.org, or you can search in Google Joseph George New Physics.